Well, hello again. Today is December the 13th. As you can see, we're plowing. We're picking corn up until last Saturday afternoon, and the snow came, and it was still coming as of yesterday, so that kind of put the kibosh on the picking. We got about 180 acres left. If we had about 4 good days, we'd finish. If we hadn't have got so much snow, we'd probably been picking today. This morning when we woke up, it was 0 Fahrenheit, so that's about minus 17 Celsius, minus 18. And probably could have picked corn, but there's just so much snow on it that it plug the combine in no time. So, being as we did get so much snow, kind of insulates the ground, so that's why we're plowing today. I'm driving the old 4960 in the 7 furrow. That's the 6 furrow ahead of me on the 7930. I had one instance where the plow actually jumped out of the ground, so I had to narrow it in a bit. There's just a bit of a crest on the ground, but it's not plowing up slabs, so I'm thinking maybe there's 1 inch, 2 inches of frost at the most. As long as you get underneath of it, you're laughing. So now we pulled into this field here, we're gonna have to finish it. Because if we leave the furrow open, tomorrow we won't be able to plow. It'll just be froze solid. So we should be able to finish it. It's about 11 o'clock in the morning. About 50 acres, which we can do in a day easy. Could be the coldest day of the year, so we got the fans running on the silos over there. Freeze the corn. And that corn in June, July will be just as cold as it is today in those big old cement silos. At least it seems to be. When you're loading trucks out of the truckload chutes, it'll actually get condensation on it because it's so cold. Well, that keeps the corn from spoiling on us. It's one of the perks of living in the Great White North. I'm not sure how the folks in the southern states keep the corn cool in the summertime or keep it from spoiling. Get the corn done before Christmas, but it is what it is. We were working on borrowed time as it was, so it was bound to come. Pretty fortunate the last couple of years. Cruising along at about 4.5 mile an hour. A little slower than we usually do it, a little narrower. But you gotta do what you can do. It'd be nice if we get another 150, 200 acres plowed. Then we'll be in good shape for the spring. Corn ground we got left to pick. We'll need it for manure anyway, so not too concerned that way. It's supposed to get a little milder through the weekend. Hopefully it'll melt the snow on the corn so we can get at it again. I'm just afraid now that the dryer's gonna freeze up on us. That could be a disaster. the joys of living in Canada. Making the old girl grunt anyway. 4960 has about 200 horsepower. We had the engine job done in the spring, so it's probably got a little bit more than that. You can't beat these old iron horse tractors. Actually, this tractor's probably worth more now than what we paid for it. Because everyone wants to get away from the DEF and the emissions and electronics, all that stuff. Other than the electric solenoid on the injection pump, you could, if you had any electrical issues, you just wire the solenoid up and keep going. We've had that happen before. It's not a big fix, but you can get going pretty quick again. Here come the crows. Probably by this afternoon, the field will be covered with seagulls. One thing I'm finding with these camera glasses is they get really hot up in the peak there. Or I should say like this, I guess I better not cover the camera. The bridge of my nose gets hot. Just hoping they don't spontaneously combust and burn my eyebrows off. Oh, they are what they are. Last year on this plow, the first time I've ever seen it happen is they broke one of the plow shanks off there, the front furrow. I've never seen